No matter how much I use electricity, I still find it incredible. A form of energy that's invisible except when it does something like cause heat. It's in everything around us in a kind of perfect balance except when you rub things you disturb it, or with chemicals as in a battery you can disturb it, or by moving it around with magnetism. And if it is trying to move, as it is here, then we call it charged. And if you have a different kind of charge and the two connect, no thank you. The trick with electricity is to put the charges where you want them to be. Then when you connect them, the electricity flows where you want it to flow. Take this welder, for example. Here's the charge terminals on the machine, electricity trying to go from one to the other. But I don't want to use the electricity over here. I want to use it on my job. So I connect my job to one of the terminals on the welder with a conductor, a wire, wrapped in a non-conductor so the charge can't escape. In this case, the non-conductor is rubber, and I connect it where I want the electricity to go. In the same way, I connect the rod to the other terminal of the welder with a conductor wrapped in a non-conductor with a special handle so I don't get zapped. Then, when I make a connection, electricity flows round the circle, round the circuit. Charge to function and back to opposite charge. Electric circles are everywhere. Every single electrical device ever made has just three basic parts: the charges, the function, and the conducting pathways. From the very biggest and the most powerful to the tiny world of silicon chips, electricity follows the same rules, the rules of the circuit. This is the heart of a silicon chip, a city of circuits in less than a single millimeter. The brain of a computer looks like this. Every tiny loop is a conductor, a pathway for mysterious, invisible electricity. In a way, electricity is like the wind. You can feel it when it moves, but you can't see it. Maybe if you could see electricity, though, it'd look something like this. It's a bit of a cheat because obviously electricity is invisible and, well, water isn't. And electricity isn't even stuff like water. But it does behave in much the same way. I mean, it can flow fast or it can flow slowly, or lots can come through or only little bits. And an electrical conductor is like a riverbed. A riverbed brings water from uphill to downhill. An electrical conductor brings electricity from one charge to a different charge. if you like, compare it to water in a fountain. This time, pipes are the conductors. The water is made to go by pressure from the pump, which is like the pressure of an electrical charge, the correct term being the voltage. The amount of water going through every second is like the amount of electric current, correct term, amperage. This may be a better comparison than a river, because here we can see that the water isn't running away. It's the same water going around and around, truly a circuit of water. The pipes of a fountain are very like the conductors in an electrical circuit. Comparisons are all very well, but conductors of electricity are not pipes or riverbeds. They are copper, or aluminium, or steel. In fact, any metal can be a conductor. The trouble with comparing electricity and other things is that electricity is not like other things, except sometimes. Where conductors are concerned, you could even think of electricity as a ghost. It goes right through solid metal, as you would see if you cut a cable in half. People say you use electricity, but you don't actually use up electricity any more than the fountain used up water. It was the same water going round and round. What you actually take out of a circuit is energy. In this case, it will be light energy. And what you take out at this end has to be put in at the other. All the electricity does is carry the energy from the energy source. In this case, a portable generator. Now, I haven't asked for any energy yet, so the generator's running quite quickly. But listen when I make the final connection to the globe. There, did you hear? The generator slowed down again. Isn't that amazing? It knew when I turned on the light. Let's ask for some more energy. Connect this one up. One and two. And the generator slowed down even more, because a circuit is a balancing act. What you take out in energy, you must put in energy. You can't cheat, whether you're using a little 12-volt generator like that one or a giant powerhouse hundreds of kilometers away. You turn something on, it feels the difference. You can't get something for nothing. But what you can get with electricity is an incredible range of different kinds of energy. There are many ways in which electricity can give up energy, but four ways stand out above all the others. These are the ones that we use most of all. First, there's heat. If we put enough electricity through a conductor, it gets hot. This is just a loop of carbon inside a globe to protect it from burning with the atmosphere. And that leads us naturally to the second effect. If you put more electricity through the conductor, if it doesn't burn, it will produce light. There are other ways of producing light from electricity. If you put electricity through some gases, they will glow, and other substances called fluorescent, when electricity hits them, will also glow. Now that's the principle of the fluorescent tube and also of the television set. Electricity from the back of the tube strikes fluorescent material on the back of the screen, and a picture is drawn in light. Heat and light. The third effect that we use most of all is magnetism. Remember, moving electricity creates magnetism, and moving magnetism creates electricity. Let's take a coil of wire, connect it to a cell, hold it near a compass, and there we can see the magnetic effect. In the same way, if we took a magnet, moved it through the coil, we'd detect electricity produced in the wire. It's mind-boggling all the different ways that have been thought of to use this effect. Probably the best example is the cassette recorder. Sound is recorded magnetically on the tape, and there we can see it proved by moving the tape near a compass. When the tape is pulled through the machine, it generates electricity, and that electricity is sent eventually to the loudspeaker. And again, it should be no surprise to discover that a loudspeaker is magnetic. But how far can you detect a magnetic field? A few centimetres, perhaps even a metre. What if you could detect the electricity in a coil of wire 1,000 kilometres away, across oceans, continents, even out into space? And I'm thinking here of radio and television, the fourth effect of electricity that we use most. How does that work? Well, the secret is, again, electricity and magnetism. If we move the electricity and the magnetism fast enough to and fro, something very strange and almost unexplainable begins to occur. It's as if little bits of electricity and magnetism rolled up together, escape the wire, and shoot off into space, never to return. Even if you turned the wire off, the bits that are already escaped would travel on forever at the speed of light, radio waves. It's impossible for me to turn the cell to and fro by hand fast enough to detect the effect. You need a special kind of machine, and that I have right over here. All it does is make electric current go to and fro in different ways and at different speeds. Let's connect our coil. First one side, then the other. Now we have a problem. We can't see what's happening inside the coil. So I've got a scope which puts a dot of light on the screen, which if I connect it to the coil will follow the current in the coil when we turn the machine on. And there it is, flowing to and fro in the coil in time with the dot on the screen, about 3 times a second, a bit faster than I could do it by hand. Now we need a detector for radio, and I've got my trusty transistor. Let's turn it on. Here we are. Let's see if it works. According to the theory, all we have to do is make it go faster. 3 times a second, 3.5, 4, 4.5. Very soon, it'll be difficult to see the dot on the screen. So let's make the dot go across the screen. A bit easier to see. And we go faster. 4.5 times a second, 45 times a second. 450 times a second, 4,500 times a second, 45,000 times a second, 450,000 times a second. Can you hear it? If you don't believe it's the coil doing that, we'll disconnect it. And it stops. And there it is again when we reconnect it. Radio waves coming out at the speed of light.